Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of the bread, open the eyes of our faith that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first reading today is from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter addressed the people, "You Israelites, who do you wonder at this, or why do you stare at us as though by our own prayer or piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you, and you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses, and by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
And now, Psalm 4, to be read in unison. Answer me when I call, O God, defender of my cause. You set me free when I am hard-pressed. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. You mortals, how long will you dishonor my glory? How long will you worship dumb idols and run after false gods? Know that the Lord does wonders for the faithful. When I call upon the Lord, he will hear me. Tremble then, and do not sin. speak to your heart in silence upon your bed. Offer the appointed sacrifices and put your trust in God. Many are saying, oh, that we might see better times. Lift up the light of your countenance upon us, O Lord. You have put gladness in my heart, more than when grain and wine and oil increase. I lie down in peace, at once I fall asleep. For only you, Lord, make me dwell in safety.
A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, as he is righteous. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus himself stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and feet and see that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. And then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed by his name in all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Oh, that we might see better times. I think that line from the psalmist was meant for just for us, for our tenacious little diocese and its faithful parishes. Oh, that we might see better times. From the words of the psalmist, through our lips, to God's ears, oh, that we might see better times. It has been a rough couple of months for the Episcopal Church in North Texas. Actually, it's been a longer rough season than that, as you stood up for your faith over 12 years ago, vowing to love as Jesus loved, respecting the dignity of every human being and striving for justice for all God's children. Your convictions led you to love and welcome all. You treat women equally and support God's divine call of women to all orders of ordained ministry. You throw open your arms to God's children in the LGBTQ community. You feed those who hunger. You love as Jesus loved. You welcome to dine at the table people in society and some churches put on the fringes. You are beautiful in the expanse of your love. In this diocese, that kind of love has come at a large cost as we lose five of our beautiful and sacred church buildings and grounds to people who do not love as you love. We must leave these holy places where in love you have baptized babies, confirmed youth and adults, ordained women and LGBT folks to the priesthood. You've married your beloved, given your children in marriage, and returned to God's care and keeping the dearly departed. We lose sacred altars where we are invited by our very Christ to break bread in Christ's name and dine with whoever happens to be at our side, because that's what Jesus invites us to do. Indeed, it's what Jesus commands us to do. Love. Love God. Love your neighbor, even those you don't like very much. Jesus knows something about the hurt you are experiencing. Jesus knows how you are suffering. For Jesus, too, was persecuted for the way he loved. He suffered at the hands of those who judged him for welcoming the outsider and dining with sinners. Jesus suffered even unto death for the sake of love. We suffer a similar death today, the death of our sacred church homes. It is painful. It is sad. It hurts. In some ways, it is like a funeral. When someone dies, we think about what they meant in our lives, remembering joys shared and challenges endured. We celebrate the life of lost, treasured memories, made and release them to God's care. I wonder if we might use the funeral model for our church buildings today, remembering joys shared and challenges endured in these places. Look around you at the beauty of the stained glass windows. Recall baptisms and weddings. Think of the countless saints commended to God's care in this place. Remember the times you have been fed at this altar, times where you were struggling and especially needed that sustenance for the days and weeks ahead, times where your heart was troubled and you came to the table with Jesus seeking peace. Recall times you came in grief or joy or simply as a matter of routine, a discipline of your faith. We not only carry our memories with us when we leave the funeral, but the impact a loved one or a friend has had on our lives. We carry whatever our hearts and minds can contain, but we also live our lives differently because of the experiences we have had. We will do the same as we leave these buildings and other sacred spaces across the diocese today. We will take not only our memories and as much courage as we can muster to move on, but also the transformation that has happened in our lives over the past 12 years. I have seen transformation in our parishes and in our diocese. You have learned who you are as church, that you, the people, are the church. You have learned to love more deeply, to give of yourselves more freely, to take leaps of faith with less fear. Your determination to carry on and let the light of Christ shine through you to your neighbors is an inspiration to me and to many who watch you in action, watch you living out the call of Jesus to love. Before we gather around Jesus' table today, I encourage you to remember. Remember your days and years for some of you, and many, many years for others in these sacred places. Feel your feelings, whether a doubtful heart, a troubled mind, a flash of anger, or downright flood of righteous indignation. Feel your sadness. Feel your pain. Jesus suffered for love's sake. Jesus dined with disciples who were confused and disillusioned and scared. Jesus suffered deeply, even unto death. But Jesus did not stay dead. On the third day, Jesus was resurrected. On the third day, we will have our third day. In John, we hear, "Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. Our parishes will be resurrected and granted new life. For most of us, the shape that will be revealed sometime down the road. Because, beloved children of God, God has plans for us that will be revealed. Episcopalians in North Texas will be resurrected and granted new life, new direction, new mission and purpose. We will see better days. We are resurrection people who will continue the way of love right here in the communities of North Texas. You are resurrection people. You love like Jesus loved. You are Christ's light in this world. Boldly let that light shine and do not let anyone put it out." Jesus said, "Peace be with you." May you know the peace of Christ in these days of waiting and unknown. May your faith be strengthened as we begin this journey to find our new promised land. May you know not only joy anyway, but joy always. Remember, you are resurrection people. Out of this death, God will bring new life. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us join our voices with believers around the world as together we profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Almighty God, we pray for your holy Catholic Church,
that we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you,
that your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, Scott, our bishop, Karen, our priest, and for all bishops, priests, deacons, and lay leaders,
that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, especially Joe, our president, Kamala, our vice president, Greg, our governor, and Betsy, our mayor,
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake. And we pray for those in command of the military and all who serve and their families at home.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. We pray for those in need, especially those we now name.
Joe, John, Angela, Addie.
We pray to you, O Lord,
that they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
And let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
For the Episcopal Church in North Texas. For Four Saints Food Pantry.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful God. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in everlasting life. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, together we pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the risen Christ be always with you. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do God's will, serving in you what is pleasing in God's sight,
and the blessing of God Almighty, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Life Sustainer, rest upon you this moment and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.